God is opening your eyes to take it.
Take your job you've been searching for.
Take your business you've been searching for. Take what you've been kind for. You've been searching for it. God is honoring you. I'm not dying there. I'm not dying in poverty. I'm not dying like. I'm not dying in stress. I'm reaching my destiny. There's a place I'm seeing where God is taking me. Can I prophesy somewhere? You are going somewhere. Are you seeing a place where other people cannot see? It's where God is taking you.
Jesus, just give him the glory. Come on, somebody lift up your hands to the King of Kings. Give him all the praise. Give him all the glory. Hallelujah. He deserves our praise. He deserves our honor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Together for Jesus. I can't see your hands. Put your hands together for Jesus.
I want to introduce to you a servant of God servants of God, Professor Apostle Jerry B. Makadanisa,
professor,
all the way from the Republic of South Africa, Johannesburg. He's among us.
I'm Professor Apostle Jerry B. Makadanisa. Oh, I am South Africa, Johannesburg.
Together with him is his wife, Prophetess Eunice Makadanisa. Let's give Jesus a big hand. I want us to give a warm welcome to the man of God as he's coming on the stage to do what the Lord has commissioned him to do. Let's welcome the man of God. Let's welcome him. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Amen. I've been working with my wife for years.
Oh, handirongo na ino daronga na yomvro dinji.
Because of one reason. I want my wife to sing this song that says, Hallelujah. They know the song.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Do you know the song?
You know the song? Before I greet you, I want us to sing this song. I have not yet greeted you. Sing, Mama. I'm excited. So let me just take you to the word of God and we share. There was a man of Benjamin, his name was Kish, and the son of Abiel, the son of Zerah, and the son of Berekath, and the son of Abia, and the son of Benjamite, a mighty man of valor. And he had a son whose name was Saul, a young man and a godly, and there was not among the children of Israel a godlier person than he. From his shoulders and upward, he was higher than any of the people. And the donkeys of Kish, Saul's father, were lost. And Kish said to Saul, his son, take now one of the servants with thee and arise and go and seek those donkeys. And he passed through the hill country of Ephraim and passed through the land of Shalisha, but they found them not. Then they passed through the land of Shalim, and there they were not. And they passed through the land of the Benjamites, but they found them not. When they come to the land of the north, Saul said to his servant that was with him, come, let us return, lest my father leave of carrying of those donkeys and be anxious of us. And he said unto him, behold now, there is in this city of Oshakati a man of God. And he is a man that is held in honor. All that he saith cometh surely to pass. Now let us go thither. Peradventure he can tell us concerning our journey whereon we go. Look here, read this one. But behold, if we go, what shall we bring the man? For the bread is spent in our vessels, and there is not a present to bring to the man of God. What have we? And the servant answered Saul again and said, behold, I have in my hand the fourth part of a shekel of silver that I will give to the man of God to tell us our way. If you read there, you can continue reading. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Let me take you to my notes of what I was hearing, because this morning I was so shocked. If you read there, you found verse 1. It says, Kish, the father of Saul, was rich. But to my surprise, in verse 2, the same Kish, who was having a son called Saul, he had servants. He had many servants. But he called his son and said, my son, take one of the servants. Go and search for those donkeys. When I read about this, I found that Saul was given a wrong assignment. The Bible says he was a son, but he was doing a job of a servant. He was a son, but he had to go and search for donkeys, which was the assignment of a servant. On verse 5, we see this boy saying, it's better we turn back. When he reached in Zuf, he said, it's better we turn back. Because our father will stop worrying about donkeys. In the Amplified Bible, it says he will be concerned about us. There's a difference between worrying and concern. Because when you are worrying, it's when you know that what you are searching is important. But concern is when you know that there is a failure, things has not been done right.
Kish,
there was a son who was sent away. He was not worrying about his son. He was concerned about the failure of not getting the donkeys. Sometimes people are concerned about you because you are not making it. They don't worry about you because they are not part of you. Kish had questions why the son and the slave are not getting the donkeys. Can I tell you something? The Bible says this boy who was a slave began to say, there's a man of God there. This man who's a boy, a slave, I'm calling him a boy so that you understand. It was not the first time he lost the donkeys. So now he knew the man, that there was a man there. And all that time, that man will tell him where the donkeys was. But that day, when Saul was doing the work of a slave, the slave will tell Saul that the reason why I was getting donkeys very fast was the man of God there. And he said, there's a man of God. And the question is, who told him? Because in his assignment, he was not failing to get the donkeys. That is why his father began to worry. He began to worry because he was questioning why they are failing. Why they are failing to get the donkeys on time. But the slave didn't want to tell Saul the secret of becoming fulfilled in his assignment. But after they've walked 5 lengths in Ephraim, that's when the slave began to say, you know what, I know there's a man of God somewhere there. If we go there, he will tell us. He was not saying, can you see my record? The reason why I'm successful in getting the donkeys when they are lost is because of the man of God. But there was a secret of reaching the man of God and also finding the answers from the prophet. And this man began to say, even Saul knew, but he said, what is it that we can bring to the prophet? They were tired and the bread was torn and everything was showing that they are as good as slaves. There was no difference between Saul and the slave. And the Bible says, when they meet the man of God, the same man called Saul could not even recognize this is a man of God. In other words, there was no sign to prove he's a man of God.
Saulo shafika kompi akalunga akakpa yeshu shingemo kwa fika kompi akalunga.
But this is the man that was having the assignment of Saul, and Saul was not even aware because he was in the wrong assignment.
Saulo okweke wete kuchompi akalunga no nandom lumenu akalunga okwe ne nyamukulo la Saulo.
It takes the grace to find your assignment. It takes the grace to find your stand. It takes your grace to find the will of God upon your life.
Oh, she pulled a filong and then I call him. She went to the area to mean my open it.
Because many people who have got the grace,
my father in a filong and then I
call bring the solution.
They think you could
your challenges.
Momo Piaka Joe,
where you are stuck struggling, but the wrong assignment you are doing. Many people were just looking at you at the distance, not understanding where you are going, but trying to reach a place on the wrong assignment. Many people who are there for solutions, you will never know that these are the people that can bring solutions unto your life. When you look at them, you can even undermine them. I'm here to tell you today somebody is going to recover the assignment he has been created for. This story is not different with the prodigal son. Not when the prodigal son was in the bush. I'm talking about when the prodigal son, his mind is recovered and he say, I'm going to the father. But the Bible says he came to his senses. But he start to speak something which is not existing. He wanted to be in a wrong assignment. And he began to say, if I can go to my father, I'm not worthy to be a son. I can rather be a slave. This is the exact story that you are in the house of your father, but you are living like a slave. You are in the house of your father, but your father is like he's not even seeing you. You are in the house of your father, but you are still struggling. You are in the house of your father, but there's no way forward. Even those who can help you, they look like they can help, they can't help you. And this man says, I'm going back to my father. When I reach there, I have to change the assignment because I'm not worthy because of my failures. And the father says, hey, this is my son. This is my son. No matter how long you fail on your assignment, but you cannot be changed by the failure you went through. I'm here to tell you because I'm hearing. There is someone here, you have failed enough, but God is still organizing your stand that He has designed you to stand, and you can't fail because God wants you to be. I'm here to tell you that you won't fail. Your past that didn't determine your future. When you go back to your father, your assignment will be restored. It will be like you are starting a journey and you are moving forward to your destiny. The Bible says there was a prophet in front. When Saul moved forward, he sees this man. He's asked the same prophet who's supposed to change his life. And he says, sorry, sir. I heard there's a prophet. I heard there's a prophet that can tell us where what we have lost. And the Bible says that man tells us, I'm a prophet.
What you
are worrying about, it has been found. But God is worrying about you. Because you are concerned about things you're not supposed to be concerned of. You are busy searching things that you think they will make you think of somebody, but God is worrying about you. And the Bible says, the prophet says, you are the one I've been searching for you. God is searching for you so that you will be recovered and take your assignment and move forward. You are the one supposed to lead and get authority from the Father. But this is the man that was really searching for donkeys, doing a wrong job that was supposed to be done by slave. His father was so rich. And the Bible says even his appearance, though he looked better, but that could not change his father. He just gave him a wrong assignment. But he was searching for donkeys, but God was searching for him. He wanted to please the father on earth, but God was giving him assignment. There is someone here. There is something you are searching, and you feel if you can't get it, you won't be you. But I'm here to tell you that God has been searching for you too. Because you are in the wrong place, you need to be recovered to your destiny, to stand where you're supposed to stand, so that you live the right life that you are created to live. People say you are a failure, but God has been searching for you. Somebody has not yet done your assignment. Your assignment has been placed there. The authority of God is coming upon your life so that you do what you are supposed to do. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I'm hearing something. Because I won't talk for long. I'm hearing something. I'm hearing that there is someone who was working a wrong job. And God is saying, hey, that job, you're not supposed to follow the job. You are supposed to follow me so that jobs will follow me. Let me say it again. There is someone here. You are searching for a job. And you are in a wrong job. But God says to me, I must tell you that God is searching for you. So if he can find you, the jobs will follow you. That's what the Bible said. Seek the kingdom and God shall follow. You have been searched for the one who owns everything. You have been searched for the one who owns restaurant, but you don't have a shop. You have been searched for the one who owns heaven and earth, but you don't have money. You have been so searched for the one who owns everything you know, but you don't have anything. But today, I'm here to tell you that today you have been found and all shall follow you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. You have been searching for healing. Can you search the living God? When you find him, he will give you the right assignment and tell you the reason why you are sick. Many of you are busy searching on the left, on the right, busy doing something that makes you zero. But I'm here to tell you, from now on, gone are the days of failure, gone are the days of shame, gone are the days of difficulty. I'm here. when things are difficult, we begin to search for solutions. God has not asked to search for solutions. Yeah, just meet a prophet will tell you, hey, you are the one, you are the one God is searching for.
You.
So I'm here as a prophet for you. I'm here to tell you that God has been searching for you. You were worrying about small things, but God has got an assignment for big things. You were disappointed and failed, but I'm here to tell you that my God will never leave you. God are the difficulties. God are what people are saying. God are looking on the past. You can look ahead. God is having an assignment for you. You have been struggling to prophesy, struggling to preach, struggling to do the work of God. Struggling. Left and right. I'm here to tell you, you will begin today. I say you will begin today in the name of Jesus. I'm here to tell you, hey, it is not too late. Until my God says it's late, you are here today. You will be recovered. You will be strengthened. You will be organized. You will be lifted. Can you shake somebody's hand? Can you say hewena? Hewena. Stop looking on one thing. There are many things that are coming. You must know your assignment. You are not a failure. You are a child of the living God. You are not a failure. God has been searching for you. I see some people who were lost for years, who went everywhere, went to this land. Others have tried to change the business to this one. Another one tried to move to another place, tried to do things, and nothing is happening. I'm here to tell you, this is the beginning of new things. When I'm busy preaching here,
it's one of the fanga.
I'm just see this woman that she was divorced. And everything was taken from
her.
And I'm just concerned, what is happening? Everything's taken. And I'm hearing God say, this is a message. This is a message. They can try to take this. But what is coming will nullify what has been taken. I want to give you chance. God has been searching for you. You need to accept him. You need Jesus. You need to come to him. You are busy with things that takes your time. But your relationship with Jesus is not there. If you want to accept, run here and stand here. Don't look at anybody. I'm calling you now, run here and stand there. You want to accept him.
Come now.
I'm speaking once, I say, come. Don't look at anybody.
You are here for your life. Don't look at your experiences. Come. If we don't call you, you are outside here a slave. Come to the house of your father. Come. I'm not carrying the position you are taking in the church. I'm not looking what you are doing in the church. It's not what you are doing, it's your relationship with Jesus. That's what matters to you. That's what matters. That's what is important. Come, I'm waiting for you. Some of you are backsliders. Some of you are battling with one thing. The mercy of God is upon you. I thank God for you who are coming from the grandstand. Bless for them as they are coming. Come. God loves you. God loves you. We are happy for you. There is joy in heaven. The decision you are taking, there is joy in heaven. There is joy in heaven. There is joy in heaven. Carry on, clap your hands for them. Clap hands for them. I see victory for you. As you are coming, run now. Can you run? Mercy rewrote my life. Come, mercy rewrote my life. Come, I should have fallen my soul. Come and pray with them.
As you came to God, as you remember that, I'm so far away from God. I have been given assignment, but I've lost it. God is searching for me to fulfill his assignment. As he sent me on earth, I have to fulfill it. As you come before the Lord in humbleness and humility, I want every one of you to repeat after this prayer. You say, Lord Jesus,
I have
come before your holy throne. Have mercy over me. Wash away my sins and my iniquity.
Before
your presence, wash him with your precious blood. Write my name in the book of the living. Delete my name from the book of the dead. My Lord Jesus, today I've made a decision to follow you. To obey your will.
No conjovo yoye.
And obey your way.
No koi pango eishi ya puke.
And commandments.
Ila meni montima wange.
Come into my heart.
Kala kalunga kange.
Be my God.
No hupifi wange.
And my Savior.
Medina la Yesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Oku janena.
From today.
mbohaiturika konjovo yoye.
I will obey your word.
Ohandikala nokuya kongeleka.
I will continue to fellowship.
Opota pautifa onjovo yoshiri.
Where there's the word of truth being preached.
Ohandikala nokukwirikana.
I will continue to pray unto you.
Nokongala pamwe na Kristo vakwetu.
Fellowship with other believers.
Metina la Yesu Kristu
naitira. In the name of Jesus.
Ohandiri tuvike koshionde Yesu.
I gather my salvation the blood of Jesus.
Nome fellowship me poya puki.
Under the care of the Holy Ghost.
Metina la Yesu daikana.
Jesus mighty name I pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. O atambulwa kwa familia ya Yesu.
You are welcome to the family of God.
O atambulwa kwa familia ya Yesu.
You are welcome to the family of Jesus.
Fikila nokumpule haro la kalunga kuchoshike kufanena.
Continue to look and ask God why he created you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Congratulations, welcome to the family of God. Thank you. You can go back.
Oh,
please lay hands only. Lift them, those who fall down. Just lay hands and lift them.
In a pocket, you can't wait to come to the man. What about my girl? My girl, my ass.
Lift those ones who have fallen, raise them up. It's a hot day, lift them up.
Yes.
Congratulations, pastors. I saw not here, but that side.
Kombi ngako.
It's a woman that chased out of the house.
Opinonka inu watata nyumbo.
I want to say, I'm not saying come out. I'm saying God is fighting for you. Don't listen, please. Don't come out.
How ino poko yapa?
Because I saw you, I could see you are the one they chase you. And the way they chase you, it's painful. So I don't want to prove what I say. I know what I say is. It's not me saying it. God is saying it. God will fight for you. Because many people, they are knowing the story of what has happened to you. And I saw your husband somewhere. So I want to say, I was supposed to be coming and ask you and say, do you want your husband back? I can clap this woman.
I took your husband.
Do you believe in prophets? Do you believe that?
Yes.
So, okay, let me call her. Come here. Where is she? Where is that lady? Come. Can you see the lady there in the back there? So, I want to ask her that question. Let her answer me.
Wandala, menu nyamu kulesha ndikupula.
Do you want your husband back?
Yes,
yes,
I want.
Because the way it has been done, God is not happy about it.
Thank
you, Jesus.
Because you are the only one person here. You know when I minister, I say, go show me the worst problem. This is the worst problem you are facing. Because since then, no one stands with you. No one supports you. It's only a few people that I'm seeing around you try to encourage
you.
I'm standing with you. Your Father God standing with you.
Your husband is coming back. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody took your husband. And there's a problem here of spirit of adultery. And there's too much of separations, fornication, adultery. But the spirit that is so dark flowing everywhere. There's going to be peace in your heart. Because you were not sleeping, crying all the time. Take my word. God has done it for you. Go back, go back. Bishop, you must tell me about this lady. Because God, this is the worst problem here. Honestly, just think of HIV. HIV is nothing. This is a serious case. There's a lady there who's HIV there. Can you stand up, sister? HIV there.
Uno HIV uri apa?
Yes, come on. That one was wearing red.
Oh, I carry kutiti yana.
Not this one, that one.
Oh, I carry kutiti yana.
You are HIV positive.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
You saw me pointing at you straight there.
Oh, what the squad de kuri ke?
Jesus has healed you.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Listen. I was hearing another story of healing and miracle. If I say you have received a miracle, go and test now. If I say you are healed, you know, the symptoms must go first. You are healed.
Amen.
I say you are healed.
Yeah.
Because there was a dirty that was coming out. Is it not true, Cecil? It was coming from your womb. So it's a sign that you will know that you are healed because this dirty will stop from now. There's a pastor here. Pastor, yes. Stop there. Yeah, pastor. And God wants to use you.
Come on, pale, kulong ife. We are the ashes. So, Papa, feel free.
That broke the ashes, yeah.
Thank you, Papa.
Because you were concerned about your dreams.
Oh, yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa.
Before you used to dream things happening.
Yes, Papa.
But now nothing
matters. Yes, Papa. Yes, Papa.
But listen to this. I don't know you.
Yes, Papa.
Is it not true?
Yes, Papa.
What is happening now? God is restoring this assignment.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Because what I'm seeing,
thank you, Jesus.
God is giving you anointing that no body will be able to resist it. Take it. They say, look here, you. There's a businessness that is coming to you.
I receive.
I want to continue. Because it is not yet around.
Okay.
You are just dreaming to make business.
It's true. Huh? It's true.
Then atangu na ifika.
And I'm seeing somebody honoring you. There's going to be a connection in financial breakthrough that is going to come to you. One of your friends is going to say, let's do this business. And when I'm looking at it, I won't mention it here.
Because
people love you. And they don't know why they love you.
It's true. It's true, man of
because
God.
Because you've got a heart. You love children. It's not true.
It's true, man of God.
You love children. Because you love children, God favors you with people around you.
Oh, yes.
It's true.
It's true.
Is it true?
Yes. It's true.
Can you just walk, go in there? Just go, walk, go in there. Because as you are walking, you are breaking a curse here. Do you know the case you are breaking? You are very much lonely.
It's true, man of God.
If you go,
it's true.
Because you don't have anybody around you.
It's true, man of God.
But this is a thing of the family. So it's broken. This curse of loneliness is broken.
If you
take it in Jesus' name.
There's a pastor here.
Stay
here.
Do you know? Go on to use it, but you must wait. I don't know if I spoke with you.
Yes,
I spoke with you.
Yes.
Because you must wait. Wait upon the Lord. Because otherwise you're going to be a prophet of doom. God wants to patch you with a prophetic anointing. Because you're the minister that is going to expand. But you must wait. Don't just dream and say God is telling me this. So you must wait and say, Lord, I need you. It's a dream. You thank God.
Thank
God.
Thank
God. So you must wait and say, let me, it's a dream. You thank God.
Yes,
because I see God honoring you. Touch your stomach. One of the ladies that was here, I was searching for her. Can you stand up? You're the one. I want to restore your marriage. You hear me? I want to restore your marriage. Where is the husband?
Church is not here.
That's why I say I want to restore your marriage. Because always you differ. You love God so much. But devil is confusing this marriage. In the beginning, everything was okay. But look at yourself. Today, when I'm standing here,
amen.
This marriage will be a talk of the town. They say there's one brother on the grandstand there.
He's
wearing white, he has been searching for job. No way. People are living in the family has left him. That brother must come running here because within 2 weeks he will get a job. Bishop, I saw people undermining you. Just let me speak with you. I saw people who are laughing at you, sir.
Bishop, on the morning,
you hear me, sir? Whatever you are doing, no one recognizes it.
Thank you, Jesus.
No one is recognizing
him.
You're a hard worker. But whatever you do, no one recognizes. I saw people laughing at you and I asked God why.
I asked God why.
And God said very soon they will see the grace upon you.
the Kalunga
Hallelujah.
I think
that listen to this. God say, change your school. Make it a university.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. And if you do that, the whole world will know your school.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
So you can hear, I'm not here to go in details. I'm telling you like you're my sister. There's a brother.
What is he?
Yes. You have been searching for a job for a long time. You are coming from the grandstand there.
Yes.
You have been searching for a job long time.
Yes, man of God.
I don't know you, yes. But I'm giving you 2 weeks.
Why could be the
you know what is 2 weeks?
Yes.
You know what is 2 weeks, my brother?
Yes.
The curse is broken.
Yes.
I want to tell you, you are going to work. Congratulations, I'm not praying for you.
Yes, man of God.
You know, I went to Mutana, I said, 1 week after dryland, 1 week there will be rain. Mama, God loves you, but I saw a stroke.
Meme, karungo kukole.
I saw a stroke.
It's true, man of God.
Eh?
This right side is paralyzed. It's not working.
It's not working.
Yes.
You are paralyzed.
Yeah.
Sometimes it becomes so numb that you have to walk like this.
100% man of God.
Can you just walk? Let me see how you walk. Stop there. How do you feel it? Now.
Oh, I'm feeling alright now.
You feel alright now?
Yeah.
You will feel alright forever. Because if I say this, somebody will say that. You, which church are you going?
First Square.
Huh? Because you love this man, he's loved my job since he's here. He's just a God. I want this thing that is in this man.
It's true.
Take it. Since he's here,
make it up.
He's playing.
What are you doing?
He's disturbing me.
It's true.
I'm hearing your prayer. You're disturbing me. Since
I love this man.
You were saying, I must give you.
Yes, it's true, man of God.
I must give you.
It's true, man of God.
There's a brother here who can walk here. What is it? Come walk. Yeah? How do you feel?
I feel something moving in my body.
Huh?
Something is moving.
What do you think? That's singing a word to language.
You don't look at him. You can't see him because we don't have a screen. Yes. How do you feel?
I feel the power of God moving in my body now.
What do you think? What are you talking about?
Huh?
Too much.
Is it too much? Ay, how do you feel?
What thing gave
you?
I just flew to this
leg.
To the leg.
To the leg, man.
Yes.
How many of you believe in the power of the living? I said there's a brother who can work. You're the one. What happened to you?
I started getting sick.
You start to get sick?
Yes.
Do you know the sickness?
I just broke the knee and the feet.
You are healed. You believe that? So you can't walk without crutches.
You do in
no.
And he's telling
the church. He's saying he can't walk without crutches. He's telling
me.
And I personally see him walking without crutches.
That's
how I'm lucky. So do you believe you are here today?
Yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe. Yes, I believe.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Walk, my brother. Can you see a man who can walk without crutches? Brother, how long you were not working without crutches? Or you were working with crutches? Let me say,
Two months.
Yeah. Who came with him? Who can confirm what he said?
Come. Who came with him? Ilaku. Yes.
Come here.
Come here.
Let me touch you here. Don't worry. Don't show me. I'm cleaning you.
Why you operate?
Because you are healed.
That's why you
come.
Inda.
In the
talking about from the
and God was telling when I come here that you are the only person who's fighting this demon of the family.
Yes,
Papa. Yes, Papa.
Yes, Papa.
Yes, it's true.
Yes, Papa.
There was a day you nearly failed to wake up.
But
this spirit was starting to press you down. Is it true?
Yes, Papa. Yes, Papa.
You remember?
Yes, Papa.
Because you are the one who's fighting, you are disturbing this spirit. I'm telling you, from now you are crippling the spirit. Listen, because of that, you are going to prosper. You are going to prosper from now.
Yes,
you hear my brother?
Yes, Papa.
Come here, let me pray for you. Can you stand up now? God loves you, but I saw somebody dead.
On Twitter matter.
And it's like they want to kill people in your family.
It's true, man of God. It's true.
Where did you bury someone?
In May this year, my sister.
Your sister?
Yes.
They want to kill people and they want to kill
people.
Even you are dreaming dead people.
It's true, man of God. It's true, man of God.
Because you dream someone calling you.
Yes, it's true, man of God. It's true, man of God.
You are also working.
I'm not working.
What happened? So you can't walk?
No.
You can't walk. Let me see how you walk. That's how you walk. Stop there. If say you are healed today, you must know you are healed. Can you just walk? You are healed now.
Again, going back to America.
Amen.
How do you feel?
I feel better.
You feel better?
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
you. You must stop crying. Because you are depressed.
It's true.
You are depressed when I come to you here. It's because you are followed by misfortune.
It's not true. It's true. Where is your husband?
Where? Yes. He's standing
there at
the
gates.
Even the marriage, yeah? Satan is shaking that marriage.
Prophet Luis.
Yes.
Because sometimes you're questioning why people are trusting your husband.
It's true.
It's not so?
It's true, Papa.
You question. My pastors are trusting your husband.
Prophet Luis, run quickly to the altar.
Yes, it's true, Papa.
Run. Someone should replace him quickly.
So, I want you to forgive
run.
Me.
Run. Yes, on that alone,
you hear me? Because God is changing your house.
Just come what I'm doing.
Number two, you are struggling.
It's true.
It's like for you to eat is a problem.
Is it
not true? You know her?
Yes, I know her.
You know her?
I know her.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, Papa.
That for her to eat is a serious problem.
Yes.
Correct.
Don't cry, Cecily. The way you're crying, you want me to stop what I'm doing.
Yes, but you're crying now.
Listen to this, my sister.
Thank you, Utana.
Somebody wait you.
Open up on no ekofingaila.
I'm tired, Papa.
Listen, you don't leave this marriage.
Enough yap on someone, enough yap on home.
Yes, Papa. This is the
husband. Oh, brother. I'm sorry I was gossiping you.
From being your pai kwambe.
Go on to change your situation.
Come, Papa, I don't do it.
Hallelujah. You hear me? God wants to change your situation. I'm not prophesying you, I'm telling you.
Jesus. I pull up here.
That from now on, the issue of being a beggar is over. Do you know that the reason why I killed her? She was going to
have left you. So close. And God
said she must never leave you. It's a journey. The blessings are coming. You must live by it. Because you're very short tempered. This short temper, this lady doesn't know whether she's supposed to stand with you or to stand with She's tolerating suffering. She's tolerating you.
This is the wife
from heaven.
Thank you, Lord.
Are you a Christian?
Yes, I'm a prophet, man of God. I'm a prophet.
This lady, she doesn't believe you.
It's true. What you're saying is true. Man of God, she, when we go home, she asks me, is this for God?
She's right.
She used to ask me.
She's very right. I'll tell you what. Because of your character.
It's true.
You're prophesying, but your character is not right.
Before you come here,
I ask
I ask a question. I don't want to spend on you, but I want you to. She questioned why people believe you.
So, oh, I pull a question. Let's get a quick time, baby.
How many of you believe that by coming here your life is changing? How many of you believe? You believe?
Yes.
Alright, let me speak with you. Mama, you are healed, eh? Yeah. You hear me? Mama, you are healed. Don't do this. You fall down, don't do this. You are healed. Can you see what she was doing? She was polishing my shoes when I touched her. Look at her. You are sick. Your stomach here is having something tight inside.
It's true.
Huh?
Even when I'm speaking with you, I'm feeling it, what you're feeling. For you, I'll tell you the prayer. I saw a house.
Amen, amen.
You have to build a house.
Yes, man of God. It's true.
You have to build a house, but you can't see the house.
Yes, it's true, man. It's true.
Always when you put money, it doesn't work for me. Tell us, sir. First of all, you and your wife, eh?
Yes.
You've been wished by this woman.
Shut up.
I don't know. Your life is a mess.
Yes, God.
Huh?
Yes,
that's what
it's
true. It's true. Huh? It's true, God. Deliver me.
Don't worry, I'll deliver you.
Amen.
Jesus loves you, will deliver you.
Yes,
God. Go! Go! So much.
Why?
It's not true.
It's true.
Pray to see the prophet to prophesy you. It's not true.
It's true.
And then even today, when you come here, your heart was denying to come. There was a demon that was there to come.
Yes, I know.
Huh?
Yes, it's true because I was supposed to wait, but I went to the doctor to see.
You could have seen something.
Yes.
All right. Listen to this. The prayer you prayed. When you, did you go to Nigeria?
I was there in Italy.
April?
Yes.
The prayer you prayed there is working for you now. You will use it at home.
Hey,
I shall take it. Take it, you will lose it at home.
Yes.
Thank you, man of God.
Because you love God so much.
Oh, Jesus.
Listen, you're an intercessor.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, I was the head of this intercession group.
No, I don't know you. I say you're an intercessor.
Yes, man of God.
Can you stand up? Where is your husband?
Samara, where are you?
You must bring unity. Huh? You need to be united so that God will use
you.
If
you people here, you join together, this man will be a prophet.
Amen.
You must pray for him.
Do that.
Huh?
Do that.
But you don't do it.
I will start now.
You start. You don't believe in him. He will tell you that I'm hearing something like this. You say what?
Yes, because people have been calling him a witch doctor.
They say what?
People have been calling him he's a witch doctor.
They say he's a witch doctor.
He's not a man of God. He's using.
They say you're a witch doctor.
Yes, they say I'm a witch doctor.
So you are believing people.
I was not believing them. I wanted to really make sure I confirmed.
Okay, yeah.
I wanted to make sure it's true. It's not.
God. So you are here to confirm to me if he's a man of God.
I confirm him, man of God.
Huh? So why I say to you, you must stand with him, pray for him.
Yes.
I'm looking at your womb.
Why
there is a problem. Tied up. Always you're complaining. Is it true?
It's true. Yes, Oshoshiri. It's true.
So the one who tied your womb, never allow you, this man is a prophet. Because if now you believe and stand with him, you will see what is happening here.
Amen.
You hear me?
Yes, I
do.
Who's Frida? Frida.
What is Frida?
You don't know Frida.
I know one Frida in our ministry.
Right. So now look here, you people here, you must pray and ask God why these people are
running. You understand?
Understand, man of God.
You want to confirm?
Yes, I want to confirm.
Confirm.
Because one day this lady, she even brought money to us.
Huh?
She brought money as a blessing.
As a what?
As a blessing, and she wants to bless us.
Who?
Then that woman, Frida.
Frida?
Yes.
So where's the money?
We give it away.
Even today she came while we were waiting for you. She came to me.
Frida is not your friend.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Because you see, I will not hear people to make you fight. When somebody give you money, ask why you give me money. Because this money can block many money. When somebody come and say money, you must ask for what?
Yeah,
if the person says, I'm so easy, say, no, please, you want to give me so that I eat it? You say, okay, yes, okay, if you are giving me, put it down here first. Because money you have received, he has rendered you zero today. Try to get money, you can't get it.
Money
is coming.
I've seen
2.5, that is coming. I say it's not the right money, don't take it. Because she loves money too much. She loved money too much.
I was not aware.
You were not supposed to have taken the money because that money has blocked you even today. Nobody is having in your home.
Because she did not bring to meet my husband.
She was bringing to me.
But you show your wife.
Yes, I showed my wife.
Redeem my womb.
Must redeem my womb. Uh-huh. She said, "Must redeem my womb." Come here. Go
want to use your husband. But they will carry on attacking you if you don't believe your husband.
It's too much.
They call me a traditional doctor, even those ones that are men of God.
Even men of God?
Yes, they call me.
They are not men of God. How different? Press. Beat it. How different?
I'm not feeling the sharp pain that I used to feel. It's a thread that is...
Beat. Can you beat on that beat? You have to remember that. If you are sick, you are healed wherever you are. I say, if you are sick, you are healed. Can you come up, brother? Yes. What you are hearing is the Spirit of God upon you.
Amen.
So don't undermine it. Because sometimes you question.
Amen.
Is this power, what is happening? Be ready for me. Listen to this one.
I'm here. I've been waiting for you, Papa. I'm here. I am here. Please.
By what you say?
Release me from that cage. I want to be young again, Papa. I want to be young again. Release me from that cage, Papa. Release me, Papa. Please release me, Papa.
Listen.
I lose my wisdom and destiny, Papa.
I love this one. You know, listen to this, my sister. I'll tell you what I saw.
I put on very strong.
I saw a ghost.
And I'm going to see you.
I saw a very big man. That is coming to inject people with us. You are suffering.
I don't even know who I am. If I reach my life line somewhere, if I make a project, it dies. If I get a car, it breaks. My house is not.
Can you hear?
My son and me are working for 14 years, Papa. Nothing. My mother, I want to build her house. Nothing. Everything I can to ask for. The cars are dying. They are just bringing me, Papa.
Look at this man, what he's doing. Look what he's doing. He put money in my... Take the money. I'll show you the person you can give. Come to me. Can I give this man? Give to this man.
Because God wants to make you to be like him.
Amen.
There's the poverty is going. The light of God will come upon you.
Amen. I see.
You will begin to see.
Thank you, man of God.
Amen. Because that's what you are crying for.
Yes, Papa.
Huh?
You are right. You are right. You are right, Papa.
Where do you come from?
I'm from Ondangwa.
I was in Ondangwa. Where were you?
I was there, Papa.
Do you know that God, I will see a light coming to you.
I receive it.
Are you a pastor?
Yes, Papa.
Oh, thank you, Lord, for lifting this man.
Thank you, Jesus.
You say it won't fail.
Thank you.
Let it happen. Jesus.
Yes.
You know you're going to. Can you see this tower? Can you see it? You don't know what I want to do with it. Give me a chance. Give me. From now on, when you pray, God will show you what to pray for.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. And I receive Jesus' name.
Because you love God, you pray for everybody.
Yes.
You want the work of God to continue.
Yes, you know, that's true.
And you don't want to, you don't want stories.
Exactly. It's true. I went through a lot, yeah? I went through a lot.
That's what you normally say, that you have suffered too much.
Yes.
And you don't want to go back to the things of the past.
Yes.
May God raise you here.
Amen.
But listen. I saw people who are against you in the church.
That's true, men of God. Very, very, very true.
They say you think you are special.
Exactly.
Forgive them.
I forgave them already. Thank you.
I even saw what happened to you. You? Yes, I saw it. Huh? I saw what happened to you. Tell me. My sister, I saw what happened to you.
And the money is going to give up.
Yes, men of God.
This thing started when you married.
Yes, men of God. Yes, men of God.
Where is your husband?
He's at the village, men of God.
Huh?
At the village, men of God.
Do you know that you're the only one who married a special way?
No, men of God.
Eh?
No, men of God.
Because God wanted to make you an example to the family.
But
look at your marriage.
It's true, men of God. It's true, men of God.
Your marriage is a joke. Because I see people laughing here. The mind of the husband was turned.
It's true, men of God.
I mean, it's like you have got a baby.
It's true, men of God.
It's like you are staying with a baby.
Yes, men of God, I'm suffering too much for this man. It's true, men of God. It's true, men of God. I'm suffering for this man. It's true, men of God. It's true, men of God. Deliver him, men of God. Deliver him, men of God. It's true, men of God. I'm suffering a lot, men of God.
Who's Maria? Maria. Who's Maria?
Oh, it's my colleague working with men of God.
Huh?
I know Maria, my colleague awake with men of God.
Why are you sharing problems like that? Because Maria, she talk too much, you know.
It's true, men of God.
Huh?
100% true, men of God. It's true, men of God.
Because this story said here, it said that it reaches your husband.
It's true, men of God. Is she even creating stories?
Huh?
Is she even creating false stories, men of God? It's true, men of God.
I'm talking about Maria.
Yes, it's true, 100%.
There's another lady here who knows Maria. What is it?
It's true.
It's you.
Yes, Papa.
You know Maria.
Yes, we are colleagues.
Your colleagues.
Yes, Papa.
You know how Maria talks.
Yes, Papa. Yes, Papa, I know her.
So Maria is what said to be.
It's true.
You know what Maria is doing?
Yes, men of God. Some I know, men of God. Yes, some I know. Some I know, men of God. 100%, men of God.
What is it that he wants to happen?
Oh, to deliver my husband, men of God.
Yes.
Your husband is having a spirit of lust.
Yeah, it's true, man of God. It's true, man of God.
You know him?
100%.
You also know him?
No, she told me everything about the husband. What you are saying is
what I'm saying.
100%.
Give glory to God. Do you know that's the reason why I'm here? Because
yes, man of God.
You are created to be example in the family, but now you're a joke. Don't fight Maria.
You know if Maria.
Yes. It is the evil spirit.
Yes. Thank you.
Forgive your husband is coming.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
You are surprised. You know Maria.
I know her.
What is that you know about Maria?
She's trouble. Everywhere. She's trouble, Papa. She's trouble.
Troublemaker.
She's a troublemaker.
So if I just say problem of the husband, whatever, and I don't mention Maria, she won't believe me.
Gang, you need to blame Maria. More case,
I want to encourage you.
Yes, Papa.
Let's forgive
him.
Our God is God of is a God of judgment, but also of mercy. She must be saved from now.
Yeah.
Okay, congratulations. God bless you.